Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of a Linux tutorial video. And in this episode, we are going to discuss about permission management on files and directories. As you know, Linux is a multi-user system, and that is why it is very important to manage the files with the right kind of permission. And in Linux, everything is treated as a file, including hardware devices and system resources. Even directory is treated as a special file type. And this is common behavior in most of the Linux distros or Unix-like systems. So each file or directory has a set of permissions assigned to it. And if you do ls-l, you will see what kind of permission is assigned to these particular files and directories. Out of these 10 bits, the first part, this one, is designated to represent the file type. So if it is a D, that means this file is a directory. There is no file here. Let's create one file real quick. And if it's a blank, it's a regular file. Let's go to desktop. I think I created one link here. Yeah, so if it's L, it means it's a symbolic link, meaning this folder right here, this directory is actually a shortcut for this directory. So link directory, like we call shortcut in Windows. And if there is a C here, that means it's a character device file or character special file, which means that particular file or device can transmit the data character by character. And if there's a B, then it's a block special file. That means that device, which is treated as a file, can transmit data block by block. For example, if you do, see this particular, this is a hard drive, which deals files in block by block, and the file type is block special file. So this first bit is designated to represent what kind of file we're dealing with. Then after that, the three sets of permission is designated for a user who owns the file. So in this case, this is a user who owns the file, and this is the group who owns this file. So in this case, a user, Umesh, who owns this file, has read and write access. And the next three sets is for the group owner. In this case, Umesh is a group, and any member of this Umesh group has read, write access. And the third set is for other users, which is not the owner or the group member, but someone else. And that user has only read access to this file. So let's go ahead and dissect this individual permission, and we'll go and see how we change this permission to files and directories. So now out of these three permission, the first is read, second is write, and the third is execute, which is represented by letter X. So these permissions define the access modes for files and directories and work similarly, except there are some subtle differences on how it works on a file versus on directory. So let's talk about it now. So on a file, a read permission means you can read the content of a file or even copy the content of a file. And write permission simply gives you capability of modifying the content of a file. And execute access allows users to run it as a program. If it's a code or a shell script, you have to, like we did this during our shell scripting chapters. But on a directory, a read permission means a user can list items inside a directory, which is basically reading the contents of a directory, like we do ls-l. /home/umesh is a directory. So read permission gives you that feature or that access. A write access allows of creating and deleting files within the particular directory. And execute allows to pass through the directory using cd command. Like for example, if you didn't have the execute permission on a folder, you could not do cd and go inside that folder and traverse it. All these commands, like ls and cd, ls-l/. If the bin directory didn't have executable permission, we would not be able to run the ls command or cd command, because these commands are stored inside this folder. So we have to navigate to this folder to execute these commands. So this permission is very important for this folder. And this is how Linux controls the rights and permission to the folders and directories. And now let's talk about how can we change the permission of any file or directory. So chmod is the command to change a permission of file or directory. And there are two ways of doing it. One is using symbolic representation of permission, and another one is absolute representation using numbers. So let's try symbolic first. And in symbolic, you can use plus, minus, and equal sign to add, remove, or set permission respectively. For example, the file that we just created, test.txt, has read and write permission for the user, read and write for the group, which is Umesh group, and read permission for other users. So if you want to add write permission to other users on this file, you could simply do chmod and other is represented by letter O, and plus means you're adding W test.txt. So you're adding write permission to other users on file test.txt. And if you ls-l, you'd see write permission for other users, which was not here before. And similarly, you can add executable permission for the user and use for user test file. And you could do group, Z for group, add executable permission. Now if you do L, so test is now executable file, the color changed. Read, write, execute for user, read, write, execute for group, and read, write for others. And if you do chmod user equal rw test.txt, what it will do is it will remove the executable permission and only set R and W permission, read and write permission, to this file. So equals means set. Whatever is there before, it will remove it and set this permission. And this is the new permission. Very easy. And you can also combine those commands into one line. For example, if you want to change something, let's remove write permission for the users, comma, remove executable permission for the group, and add executable permission for others. So you can combine like this. So now we remove the W permission for the users, write permission for the users, so it is only read only. We removed executable permission for the group from here, so no executable permission. And we added executable permission for other users, which is RWX for others, and read for user, read and write for group members. And if you need to set same kind of permission for all user group and others, you can also do chmod, A means all. Let's do read write for all in that file. So it added write for the user, did nothing for the group because it already had read write access. And for other, it didn't change anything because it already had read write access. But if you do similar command, but set or equal, then what it is going to do is it is going to remove the existing permission and set read and write access for user group and others. So it just removed the previous permission and set read and write for user, read and write for group, and read and write for others. So set or equal sign will remove the existing permission and set the new one, which you define here. So it's set for all three groups, user group and others, read write access to the file. So it's very simple, easy to understand, and very handy tool. Now let's talk about numeric representation of these permissions. In numeric representation, read permission has a value of 4, write permission has value of 2, and execute permission has value of 1. So we give rights to the user group or others by combining this numerical value. For example, chmod 664 means, so 6 is the combination of 4 and 2, which means read and write. And another 6 for group is also read and write. And 4 for the other users is for read only. So if we do this, what happens is, so user has read and write access because 6 is the combination of 4 and 2. 4 is for the read, 2 for the write, and 1 for the execute. Group has read and write, and other has only read access. So it's going to remove W from other and keep read, write for user and group. There you go. And if you want to give read access only to everyone, then you can simply do 444 test.txt. Only read access to everyone. And if you want to do read, write, and execute permission to all, that means 7, 4 plus 2 plus 1 for the user, 7, 4 plus 2 plus 1 for the group, 7, 4 plus 2 plus 1 for the other. And it will do RWX, RWX, and RWX for all. There you go. Very simple. This one is probably easy to implement and use in daily basis once you get the hang of it. The alphabetical representation is probably easy to understand at first, but numerical representation is probably easy to do in daily basis if you're using it a lot. One thing you have to be careful with numerical representation is that it can only be used to set rights for all users. So if you're changing a permission using this method, you have to calculate the new permission for all and compute new value and then use the command. For example, you cannot do chmod 600 test.txt to set read and write access to user and hoping that this permission will stay same. It doesn't work like that. So what it's gonna do is this will remove the permission from group and others and set read and write for the users. So if you do 00 means there's no permission for group and others, it'll just remove it. Say it removed all the permission from group and others and just set read and write, which is 6, 4, and 2 for user. You must mention the existing permission for other groups that you do not want to change the permission for. For example, in our same case, if you do not want to change a permission for a user here, you still have to do 6, which is the existing permission. And now if you want to add read only for the group and read only for the others, then you can do that like that. So just understand that whatever the permission you give will be the new permission for the file. It will override the existing permission. It's very simple. I hope it's not very confusing. So this is the first part of file permission. I made this video very short so that we can understand the permission and practice it. And in the next part, in the part 2, I'm going to talk about different tools of the same file permission management, changing the ownership and changing the group. This is a very handy tool, and this is probably one of the most useful commands in Linux when you're dealing with multi-user files and directories. And if you want to give permission to one user or the other and restrict the permission for the files and directories, this is the command that you're going to use. So let's end this part 1 video right here. Make it short and simple so that you can understand the concept and practice. And I'll continue the rest of the commands in part 2. So I'll see you in the part 2 video, and thanks for watching.